Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and this is From the Depths Designer, where this episode we're going to be building a ship, because that's what you do in designer really, is build and more building, which is the bit I like doing anyway, so this is a good place to be. So what is the plan for this episode? Right, well, we're going to see how it goes. This is going to be a multi-part episode. Well, or more or less a separate season. This is going to be the start of the epic ship build. So we're looking at a really, 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 really big ship that's going to take all of the bits we've learned from all of our other ships and put them into one very large ship. So what is the plan? Well, it's going to be big. So points, blocks-wise, we're mostly hitting, if we go over 20,000, I'm going to guess by the end of it, it could well be bigger than 20,000 blocks. You know, this is going to be a massive single ship, which basically going to be taking on lots of defences against people like lasers, for people like the Scarlet Dawn, and other ships and vehicles that might try and come against us. So it's going to be shielded, smoked, anti-missile missiles, you know, interceptors. It's going to have big guns. It's going to have missiles. It's going to be a multi-role massive ship. The intention is we put it against a force or a base and it obliterates. That's the hope. So it's total overkill. You know, which I don't tend to like doing. Totally OP, overpowered for the level we're going against, to be honest. But this is going to be an end ship. I might bring it in beforehand, and you may be seeing this video after it's actually been brought into the campaign. But this is going to be the build. That's why this is going to be over quite a few episodes as I sort of learn things. So let's start with a block, because we can't really go anywhere. That's not what I wanted to do. What I want to do is go in here, new object, vehicle, because it's going to be a vehicle. And the other thing I'm going to try, so that's forward, I'm going to try and have this go as a trying to think of the right wording here, as a multi-level vehicle. And by that I mean it's gonna potentially be able to go at different heights. I would like it, obviously, well, I say obviously, I'm gonna have it as a sub to a great degree, but I'm also want it to be able to fly. So possibly it will be flying when enemies aren't within a reasonable range, so it can close in fast, and it, once it's in combat mode, especially against any sea vehicles or low vehicles, it'll go into like a deep water sub mode, and we'll have various defenses set up for the different variable heights that this ship may go into. I think that sounds like a good plan, or an idea of a plan as such. Yeah, we'll see how that goes. I've got some ideas for some unusual weaponry and some alternative methods of everything from combat propulsion missiles, and it's all just ideas at this time. Right, I don't know how many I've done there. So I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We'll do 10. Now this is gonna be a symmetrical design, slightly cylindrical. I'm just setting out a central base area that is gonna be used. Now I'm gonna want to go symmetrical the other way now, just to set out a different plane. Alright, so I want to go on this plane now. Is that... Nope, that's not done it as the way I want it. No, come on. I want to go to a horizontal plane. No, it's vertical. It's going vertical that way. No, that still has not done where I want it to. Come on, come on, come on. Vertical planes. Vertical plane. Okay, let's aim it that way. That's better. Okay, let's go down one. I'm doing this in keyboard mode. I think I'd have been better off doing it in mouse mode, because that's my preferred way. But if I go here, is that in the center? Let's see if that's going to be correct. If I go up one. No, that's not in the vein I want it. Okay, let's do this with the mouse then instead. So I'm trying to set up a it through that. There we go. I know if I got into mouse mode it would be better. So if I place one, let's get in the center. There we go. That's exactly what I want. So I'm gonna set out, what I'm doing here is just setting out the basic cross. Now I can go into keyboard mode. There we go. Because it's quicker for these things. What I'm setting out is the basics height for everything. So that's two. Because I did say this is going to be a big ship. I will time lapse a lot of this video when I'm doing stuff like this, potentially. Although at this moment I'm chatting. So that's fine. And I'm rambling and ranting and all the rest of it. So we will try and keep it sort of semi-symmetrical in a cylindrical style of design. Because it's going to be big, we might have some AI troops on this. I tried using them on the Atlantis, and they didn't really work. But we might try putting a few more on. I'm going to make this a ship so that there's doors in it, and we can go around most of the places, so the AIs will be able to wander around. And I'll put some weaponry on here that they will be able to use. So let's just see, if I go this way just to see what the height is. Yeah, that's right, so that's correct. Okay, let's get rid of that mirror line. Okay, now have I done anything wrong? No, just, yes, because of that wooden block. Let's take that wooden block out. Right, so, front, rear, I don't know where I was thinking. This is mainly going to be body, I'm thinking, the body of the ship. Near the back, this may go out even further. I might, rather than being a perfect cylinder, although I want it slightly cylinder, I might actually expand this out a bit further, or potentially the center will narrow a little bit, or give us a little bit of aerodynamics for the ship. And we'll just see how much of this. I've set this up, but we might not need all of this particular space. We might find it's a little bit smaller is perfectly adequate. Right, stage one, let's think. What I'm going to start with, I've got an idea for a really big spinal gun. I'm thinking of the Enterprise spinal lance. So what we're going to build now is our main offensive cannon for against ships. This will be our, I'm going to call it the doomsday weapon, the weapon that is used to obliterate the enemy, basically. I'm going to take out that one, and it's going to be right down the center of the vehicle. Is the aim. So we're going to put our firing piece, just there. Excellent. And then what we would do is all of our six ways. Let's see, we need a mirror line. I'm going to come out here. And yes, it's going to be total overkill, so not worried. Let's get back up here. It's easier to move around with the mirror without that. Okay, we'll go here and we'll put a mirror line. No, I want one down. Okay, this way. Please, sir. Please. Alright, okay. Look down on it. Point at the block. There we go. Alright, so. And just here, we will put... I just undid what I just did. Oh, I'm a silly boy. Silly boy, Pike. There we go. Alright, okay. And this way, out a little bit more. There we go. There we go. That should do. That's for all of our... blocks. And actually, I've looked at that now, and I don't like that. I don't like that. No. I don't like that. I think I'm going to put them on... this bit instead. Yeah, I think this will look better. About that. I just suddenly didn't like the looks of that cross. I think this is possibly a better design. Can go out a little bit better. Yeah, that's much better. Okay, so start off barrels. Barrels. We obviously need a elevation barrel, which we will put on first, because that will give us our nice 80 degrees. And we're going to try and keep this to roughly 80 degrees. It's going to be, primary is going to be accuracy. It's not going to fire very quick. It's going to fire far, about, well, 3,500 is the limit for the cannon. So it's going to fire about 3,500. But the main bit is going to be, it's going to fire accurately. But it's going to keep the firing at... It's not going to be on a turret, as we've, as you can tell with the way I've started this. Because I'm a little disenchanted with turrets. So it's mainly going to be static with a 45 degree sort of compensation. 45 degree angle. Possibly 80. I'm debating a couple of choices here. At the moment, I've got 80 up and down. So if it goes over the top of something, we should still be out of fire. So what have we got here? Elevation, we're keeping that azimuth 22. So it's got to be pointed at the target as far as left and right goes. So horizontally, but vertically, it's going to have that 80 degrees. Now, in inaccuracy of 0.29, we can obviously go better than that. Let's put, let's see if that's gone too far. 0.13, but it's reduced our it's reduced our elevation, words are failing me, but you know what? It's reduced. It's reduced that stuff. We don't want the stuff being reduced. So let's see. Now I could just do this all with motorized barrels, I suppose, but they don't give enough accuracy. But I could just put up lots. All right, where's that menu? 0.25. Okay, so now don't do it this way. So we go down. Sorry about that. Having a multi-screen setup, I accidentally tabbed out, and then my mouse got stuck on the second screen, which basically means that I wasn't able to every time I clicked, it would just alt-tab out of the game totally, which is not a good thing. So, okay, we're back in again. So I'm putting plenty of motorized barrels here, and now I'm going to put the recoil barrels. And what we might do once I've got this done, because one good thing is this gun effectively will clip through anything we place to the side, because it's the nature of the way that the game does cannons. So I'm actually thinking, oops, is that still kept the right ratio for the elevation, etc.? Yep. Is we could actually build a lot of our ship next to this gun, because we need it pointing out the front, but not too far. And we can see we've got quite a bit of distance there. We're nearly there. Nearly there. I want to get to that 0-0 point. And I've lost count of where I've got to. 0.1. Oh. Couple more. I think it's around 50 barrels we're looking at. Well, that's a 0.01, and it just lost the elevation. So what we'll do is we'll put 3 motor drivers on, just, and this will be for looks, and then a recoil, 2 recoils. See if that brings it back. Need to take another 2 motor. I'm putting recoil suppression on here because I don't want the recoil too high once we start putting the gauges on. There we go. So how many barrels have we got there? So that's 15. Now the easiest way to do this is with those, so that would be 19, 23, 27, 31, 35, 39, I hope I'm doing this right, 43, 47, and then we're going to go up to a 49. Yeah, so it's about 49 barrel gun. Okay. We will actually put some metal there afterwards, just as protection. And then what I'm thinking is this bit here effectively becomes the front of our gun, for want of a better reason. Now we'll just put a... Let's see if I can just put on the end a normal barrel, just to finish it off. Let's just see, make sure that hasn't done any problems. Note that makes it nice, a nice 50 barrel gun. Okay, next we will need some reloaders, obviously, but I'm not going to aim at getting this hyper fast firing. It's not the intention of this particular build. I'm doing this the wrong way around, bear with me one second while I get my thing into order. There we go. Go there, and we'll start by putting in a mirror line down here, so we're going to mirror things below us. No, wrong level. There we go. I'm not sure where that's mirroring. That's not mirroring where I expected. Oh. Let's try that again. Point in here. Mirror line. No, wrong level. Was that in? No, see, that's not quite on the right level. Why is that doing that? There we go. That's on the right level now. Okay, now that I don't need it, we'll put some ammo barrels around here. Now, actually, what I'm going to what I'm going to do is put some of the gauges in. Now the gauges here, I'm thinking at the same time are going to end up as some good armor because they have a high armor value. So if we go to gauges here, if we go back to the gauge here just to check, on the left hand side, armor is 10, health is 150. So health isn't great, but armor having 10 is quite good. So we'll just put a whole load of these in. We are totally ODing on gauges. Why not? All right, so I think that's got a gauge everywhere. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, about 24 gauges. So I think that will be enough to get us the full 3,000 range. Most we could get a few more in there just to get a little bit more damage. Kinetic damage, 2,385. So anything small this hits, goodbye. Armour, okay, next. We'll be putting some bits in there for the armour piercing. Get that up to 12.8. So we will just do the same again. We'll put a we'll see how many. We're going to get one, two. No, I think we can do it without putting that frontal part on this. Let's just go to armour piercing warheads. We'll put another row in there. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 10. So if I put one down there, that'll be 12 for each row. So we're going to put another 12 in. It's going to be one of those more than I actually need. But I've got the blocks available, and as we said, this is not going to be a hyper efficient. There's been some lately some changes possibly coming in that non-efficient vehicles will cost more fuel or something to move around, or will have an upkeep. So this would be an extremely heavy upkeep. So we've got an AP of 12.8. We'll put one more round in there for no benefit whatsoever. I could actually move all of these back, which is potential. There is another reason. Okay, what I'm going to do now though is I'm going to put some metal blocks in here now, because these were all fairly non-explosive as far as damage goes. So if we were to get hit in this section, it wouldn't blow the whole gun up. Now we're going to be putting in ammo boxes on the HE. So HE definitely, explosive warheads, definitely gets blown up. So we're going to put two in, and then basically a firewall all around it of metal. So that's 12. Explosive damage 385. Right, we'll put one, then we'll put some metal around here. Because I dislike the whole, we do get an issue with the enemy's lasers do tend to have a very, what should we call it, an effect to be able to pick out the most vulnerable parts of our craft, and this would definitely be a vulnerable part if they managed to get into all of these explosives. I haven't even thought about where I'm putting explosive ammo barrels yet. We'll work that one out later. I might put them in somewhere where it's not as critical. What we got there, that's explosive damage 497. I think we'll, whoops, have I doubled up on some of that? Maybe I have. Didn't want to. That was supposed to go in there, I think. There we go. Right, one more, I think. One more round, then we'll put some just ammo boxes in. Which are also explosive, and we do have to be a bit careful with. Right, I think that's all the way around. Yep. Okay, one more HE box, which would give us about 36 of them. I just need to take some of that. That comes out there. There's a block there. There we go. Just spotted it. Otherwise, that could have been disastrous. Well, not disastrous. Just not to plan. Which is also disastrous. Don't run things not to plan. Now, if they manage to hit this far back, basically, good luck to them. And they would blow the crap out of the whole craft anyway, to be frankly honest. So, maybe I haven't got to worry quite so much. But in for a penny, in for a pound. Right, now we just need ammo boxes on their own. So what's the reload time at the moment on this? Okay, so we need some more on these here. I'm not wanting it to fire too many times. I don't want the actual reload. This is not machine gun. 0.68, that's fine. Don't want any more reload time than that. So now, what I can do for the ammo barrels is like this. I'm thinking, yes, right, what we're going to do is we're going to put a separation in here again before it gets to the rear part of the main gun, which is going to have all the AI and the main firing piece, etc., etc. So we're going to put another final break here all the way around. I should be doing some of this with beams, but this will do for this moment for this particular section. I'll worry about that when we go to the main part of the body. The beams would also be more powerful. So just trying to even this up a little bit, just to make it sort of semi-symmetrical. Right, now, ammo boxes. I'm actually thinking here to come up here a little bit, 1, 2, 3 as well. There we go. So how much ammo, etc., has that given us? So I'm going to make a hole here, because if I want to be able to get down, I know where I need to go to get to the firing piece. There we go. So ammo, 10,000 with 54 per ammo use. So that would be 5,400. So we've got 200 shots before it needs to roughly just under 180, 190, something like that, shots before it would need to reload. That's good enough. At those damage rates and everything else, that should wreck things quite adequately. Now, what I will do here is I will use beams. I'm going to use some metal beam. Going this way. There we go. One. Just to fill this in a little neater. on orient. There we go. It's one of those, whilst I'm here, I might as well complete it in that way. There we go. Right, let's just make sure that has, I haven't actually just destroyed the whole gun, as has happened in the past. 524, that's still 54. Inaccuracy 0. Elevation 80. Azimuth 22. Reload time 0.68. That's good enough. Kinetic damage 2385. Oh, I didn't see what the recoil was. What was that recoil that we're going to have to go against? Recoil 1. Cool, because I've used basically recoilless barrels here instead of using normal barrels. Although it wasn't, I had to use more barrels to get the accuracy, it basically means I've got almost no recoil from this, which is very good. Very good. I'm liking that. Okay, just seeing if there's anything I've missed. There was an option, possibility for some more barrels there. So we've done that. Okay, I've got to do this one here as well. So if I do that to there, yeah, that looks quite nice. So if I, there we go, that looks quite nice now, and then we can just put this down here to basically cover up the gun in some metal to out to most of its distance. Okay, let's work out where the actual center is, because down here I didn't do that to exactly the right spot. So that's its true center point. Then, yeah. Oops, I took something out I shouldn't have. There we go. And here, have we put that in the center here? Yes, we have. Oh. Now, most of this will actually be inside the ship, I think, now. This won't be pointing out like this. We'll be shaping it to fit, basically. So this will be inside with it. We'll put some blocks here just as to add as some extra armor as such. From anything that's straight ahead firing straight through, it's going to have to go through a considerable amount of metal to be able to get to the main parts of this gun. As such, cool. This is bigger than expected, bigger and better and just big, better, big. And even betterer. It's a new word, betterer. I'm sure many children use the word betterer, and they didn't realise that it's an unofficial word used by many people. I'm sure. Betterer. And then we'll just do some convergence here, which will be a... we might be able to do it, actually go back one. Here, put the converted core with the corner like that. Aim to the side. There we go. Then we put the metal corner in here and here. There we go. Let's make sure I haven't missed anything out. That's good. Now I could actually just leave it like that with the point sticking out, but I think what we'll do is we'll now just put some slope down here. Is that to be even? That's not joining up. That one there is the wrong way round. Because this one here is the wrong way around. This mirror line's not working. Let's take the mirror line off here. It's put it in, not, hasn't mirrored it correctly. Let's just take, that one is also off, and that one is also off. It's mirrored it too literally. That's better. Now we'll put these in manually. And finally, this slope. So, okay, I'm OCD complete. Round one. So it's pointing through. Now, when it actually aims, it will pull out to the side, etc. So that's fine. Now I'll just put a, I'm going to put a little bit more armoring in here because we have no limit on blocks in this particular vessel. We're going for maximum size and just regularity. I'll put a few more blocks in here just because I know there's some lasers out there, and I'm sure some of the Scarlet Dawn lasers will be Uber style lasers that will burn through about 3 blocks in one shot. That's the power of lasers. Now, okay, this is a debate or a point of thought. Should I have lasers? I have thought about it. Maybe an anti-missile lasers. But I'm going to use smoke on this. So, potentially, I'm not going to need lasers. Right, we're going to fill in at the back here. This will help cover in, give us a bit more defences and cover in this block so it looks a little more even. Oh, that's not 4. That's annoying. Were these single blocks? No, they weren't. Ah, okay. I missed a trick there. Never mind. We'll sort that one out later. You can have that. You can go there. That looks symmetrical. Trying to make sure that where possible it's symmetrical up and down. Because this is going to be very heavy, central part, when it comes to balancing this ship, if I've got anything which is just out somewhere, it makes it a lot more difficult to eventually try and balance up later on with the propulsion. So getting that right at the beginning is rather important. I'm going to go a little bit of finning on the top because I just felt like it. That looks good to me. It's a little bit of design as well as anything else like that, as well as armour. So it's sort of pulling back in size. In actual fact, I could actually put some sloping in there just to... Oh no, actually what I'll do is put that on there and then I'm going to go like this. And the same on the side. What'd be nice is a mirror, like a, I'm trying to think of the right word, but a point mirror, so you can point to a center part and it would go symmetrical down the center, so I could aim at the point of the barrel and it'd do all 4 sides. So rather than mirror, it's like a quad mirror. That'd be interesting. don't need this here, and I don't think this will be pointing out. It's just I'm having a moment, and I'm just deciding that I want this to be nice and sort of symmetrical, even though it doesn't actually matter and it's going to be inside the ship. I'll leave it there. Obviously what I'm I've got to do this. There we go. That's adequate. So when you're walking around the ship, you'll be able to see how much detail I have put into making sure everything is nicely laid out. Because obviously, when the AI has to go around and service this ship, they want to be able to see all the work I have put into this. And laugh at the bits I get wrong. And then we're going around with spirit. Well, that's not level. Oh, I don't know about that. Could have done a better job there, you know. And at which point I will take it up to 10,000 feet and throw them out the airlock. Because that's the type of captain I am, as such. Okay, I'm going to fill this out a little bit afterwards. So this is going to be the main gun now. So we've got the main gun is finished. I'll fill in these blocks in a minute and then we'll get on to the next one. So spinal gun complete. I might reduce the size of some of this back here and actually move it forward. So take this along the gun a bit. Because this part isn't going to move, I can use these areas here as for certain parts of the ship potentially. Possibly start looking at the shaping from this center part. We'll see how that goes. So leave any comments below. Obviously this is going to be completed by the time you see it, so any comments you make won't be changing the actual values of the ship. It will just be any comments on what I've done, or maybe things I can change after the battle. But after the build. But until next time, have fun, come up with some new ideas, keep building those ships, and most of all, keep playing.